Hello friends, my name is Surreal Emil and welcome back to some more Forza Motorsport 2. Today we're continuing on with our Let's Play. This is episode 24 and in today's episode we are going to be taking a look at another one of the Manufacturer Club races, this time taking a look at the Porsche Sports Car Cup. For that of course, we will need a Porsche, and while we have a few in our garage, I still think we're going to go out and buy ourselves a new one. Now, Porsches cost a lot of money, as you'll probably be aware, so I was going to go with the 911 Turbo, however, I think I'm actually going to go with the Cayman, because I kind of like the Cayman a bit more. I really like that colour, actually. That's a nice colour. Whatever. There's millions of colours available for the Cayman. Anyways. I'm not sure whether I should go with that or that. I think I'm going to go with that. Okay, let's buy the car. Yeah, I was going to buy the 911 Turbo, however, apparently by the looks of it, it might actually just be cheaper to upgrade the car manually to compete with the 911s and so on. Anyways, let's just quickly take a look at the weird and wonderful aero for this vehicle. Actually, the rear bumper doesn't look that bad. Anyways, I am going to go for... Ooh, I'm going to actually kind of cheap on this car. I wasn't expecting that. Now, I do believe we actually got... Oh, we got money off the cheapest tyres available. Okay, let's not use those, though. I'm going to go with the BF Goodriches. Right, how much is it to increase the tyre widths? Sure, why not? Brings us up to B691. Still got quite a ways to go, though, to actually compete with the proper Porsches. Well, I should say, not proper Porsches, I mean the other sort of 911s and the more performance-orientated Porsches. Anyways, it's not really worth upgrading that much on brakes, so we'll go with the sports brakes now. What else do I want to do? I think I'm going to go sports cams. Let's have the sports exhaust, because that'll take some weight out as well. That's five. Let's go with, yeah, sports exhaust. Apparently it doesn't take weight out on this game. Interesting. I'm just curious, actually. What can we swap into this? So that's 911 GT3 and a 911 Turbo swap. Jeez, that actually really holds up the PI, doesn't it? Right. And I'm also just going to throw in some street weight reduction on there as well. Because it doesn't cost that much money. But anyways, there we go. That's our Porsche Cayman built up. The PI is... I think it's a little bit below the lead car. I'll quickly get into what the lead cars and so on are in this race. So first off, Porsche's both historic and modern take to the tarmac in this race of Stuttgart, famous automaker. Our opponents are a Porsche GT2, a 911 GT3, a 911 Turbo, a 959, a 996 GT3, a Cayman, and a Boxster. And for winning first place, we will get the 82 GT3 Cup car. The races are going to be heading to the Mugello Short, Silverstone International, and the Mazda Raceway Laguna Seca. Let's jump into the Autodromo Internazionale Short first. I don't know why I tried to go for the Italian pronunciation there. Not exactly a particularly smart thing to do, maybe, but there we go. Hold up. Oh, never mind. Let's just scroll up there. There we go. Okay. Right, as you can see, PI-wise, we are the third best car on the grid. We are starting in fourth, though. Again, I could have sworn the grid ordering was based on PI, but I honestly don't know how they work it on some of these other races, but there we go. Anyway, straight line speed, I'm expecting... Ooh, okay, so we're quicker than the Turbo. That's kind of surprising. I was not expecting the GT3 and so on to be the better in a straight line. I'd expect them to be much better through the corners. Because from all accounts, the 997 Turbo, at least from what I've driven in previous Forza, or in other Forza games, and in real life, apparently that thing is a little bit of a dog to drive through the corners, but there we go. Anyways, ooh, yeah, I'm going to get some slideways action, there we go. No problem, buddy. Anyways, right, let's go through here. I will just throw this out, I'm streaming kind of early-ish today, just because the opportunity presented itself. I don't know if I'm going to how long I'm going to stream to. I don't know if there'll be two streams today or something, because I didn't do one yesterday, so anyways. Right. Okay, so we found out that while our car is very, very quick, it isn't as quick as a 997 GT3 or indeed the other car, whatever it is. I think it's the 993 GT2, which I would love to use. Unfortunately, I'm not quite the correct level to have access to that vehicle yet, which is a little bit not good. I would like kind of like access to it, but there we go, because I really, really like the 993 GT2. But I'm sure if the opportunity presents itself, I will be using it later on in the game. Anyways, alright, let's see if I can actually get around this GT3. Yeah, there we go, get him into the... Oh, Christ, why do they... I hate it when they do that. I hate it when they... Like, the AI on this game is... they're not quite as good as maybe they should be. Like, they have got a little bit of Gran Turismo syndrome. I know I probably shouldn't have made a dive back there, but at the same time, you know, he's just going to continue on going instead of braking, which is what most reasonable people would do. Of course, I wouldn't do that, because obviously I want to spin the cars out because I want to win, but there we go. Anyways, oh, hey, this thing does have a 6-speed. I was going to say gear ratios are long, which I was not expecting from the Cayman. I was expecting the Cayman to have sort of a really short, peppy gearbox, but there we go. Anyways, also, I just want to point this out at the time of recording. I'm recording this during the England Euro 2016 Wales match bollocks. So if you hear horns outside, that's apparently how British people signify their happiness by beeping as they go past. It's like, can you not? Like, seriously, who cares? Anyways, alright. Can we get up the inside of Rossi? I have 3 more laps to do so. In fact, the opportunity might have presented itself here. Ooh, nope, not quite. Okay, I'm going to back out of that one. That's definitely the best. If you're already beaten, hello, Daniel. If you're already beaten, like, there's no point of taking the dive, i.e. there, it would have been a little bit too risque to go ahead and do so. Anyways, breaking into here, there we go. Rossi's kicking up dirt again. They seem to go a little bit... Oh, hey, a GT2. Yes, indeed. Q, hello, welcome to Strem. That is indeed a GT2. It is M. Rossi, everyone's favourite Forza driver. Anyways, let's see if we can get past him. I need... to be fair, like, I probably will be able to beat him out. He breaks in a few places where maybe he shouldn't do. Oop, I was about to say, can I go around the inside there? I just don't quite have the straight line speed on him, and I've mentioned this before, taking dives when you haven't got the straight line speed can be a little challenging. Ooh, okay, there we go. The Cayman does not like going on the grass, but at the same time, that's like one of the only, because they hog the racing line, so it's like trying to, it just doesn't really work, to be perfectly honest. Anyways, where's the Wang? There is no Wang on this car. It looked a bit too silly. So anyways, if I had the GT2, then I'd have the mighty whale tail, but unfortunately I don't. Anyways, see, I'm tempted, I could go around the outside there. That could be a bit of an interesting dive to have. Right, I think I'm going to get him on this lap. Yep, there we go. Okay, we're up the inside. Right. Of course, we're on the outside for this particular corner, but apparently he's just going to break early into there. There we go. Absolutely fantastic. There we go. We've made the pass on that GT2. All right. Now I've just got to try and hold the lead, try not to do any stupid mistakes. Everything needs a wang. I will admit the Cayman does suit a wing. Admittedly, like, there's only Forza Aero on this, but if we're talking, like, the Cayman GT4, which is, like, a car which I dearly love, yeah. I do really like the Caymans, actually. They are, by far and away, my favourite of the Porsches. Like, I've always kind of liked the Cayman. When it first came out, like, this particular model, I was a bit divided on. The Cayman R was okay. However, you know, like, the brand new Caymans, the and Rice, not every car needs Rice. I don't think you'd Rice a DB9. I did induced, but that's not the point. Like, the Cayman is, I don't know, I've always just kind of liked this car. And especially the newer models, like the GT4 is probably my favourite Porsche right now. As much as I dearly love the 993 GT2. Like, that car is great. I love the 1973 Carrera RS as well. That's a fantastic car. But I think the Cayman's just my favourite Porsche. I don't know. It's by far and away the one that I would actually own the most. This is indeed actually kind of a dad car, I guess. It's time for dad. If dad was, of course, a divorce lawyer in California. Actually, no, he'd have a boxer in California. If it was like New York, then maybe he'd have a Cayman. Anyways, we don't quite level anything up, but nevertheless, here we go. A Honda needs rice. I mean, no. I don't know, there's some Hondas that suit themselves more to the rice lifestyle, like the Integra. You can get away with it a bit more. Civics look kind of dumb, depending on the model Civic, of course. You know, again, I put a wing on the Civic Si EK9 coupe thing, so I mean, I can't really say anything, but there we go. Anyway, Silverstone International is the next track. Now, this could be a trickier one to overtake and keep the lead on, because of course, as I've mentioned before, this one has a lot of straights. However, the AI round Silverstone, at least the, I believe it's the national circuit, the AI are a bit overly cautious. Civics look dumb regardless. Get out. Anyways. Alright. Civics look cool. Like, I don't know. I can't even think of a Civic I dislike. I'd own, get a Vauxhall Vectra. There's no Vectras in this game. There really is. We have a choice. We can use an Astra at some point, or a Monaro, which, I mean, a Monaro is technically a Pontiac GTO, which I believe is technically related to Opel in some weird way, so the closest thing to the Vectra in this game is probably the Monaro. Then again, especially that new one. Are you on about like that? Are you on about the one in Europe or America? It's like a liftback concept or something, didn't it? I do have to admit, the newer Civic is not quite as nice as the older ones. Like, I don't know, the sort of spaceship styling of the 8th gen. I think it was the 8th gen, or was it the 7th? No, it's 7th gen. The body style makes me think of Prius. Oh yeah, that one. It is a bit Priusy. Get an Astra. I could get an Astra at some point, maybe. We'll have to see. I won't particularly enjoy my time with it, but I could get an Astra at some point. Actually, there is a place where I could probably get away with it. But yeah, I don't know. The newer Civics have been ever since that spaceship styling of the 7th. Was it the 7th? I think it was the 8th gen. The Aster. Oh yeah, of course, that game, the Opel Aster. Jesus Christ, please, I've only just managed to erase my memory of that travesty. Anyways, yeah, ever since the spaceship styling, like, they took a step back, I think, with the 8th gen, and now with the 9th gen, it's sort of, you know, it's starting to look like any American. It's starting to look a lot more like just a generic-y. It's almost starting to look hybrid, like you said. And that just seems strange to me, because I really wish Honda would have kept the Insight around. Because, I don't know, the new Civic, like, at least the pictures we've seen, of course, they're, like, whacked out or whatever. So even Honda isn't sort of totally on with the styling, but it just seems like they may as well have just kept the Insight around as that sort of car, and then kept the Civic as, you know, a hatchback. There should be a three-door Civic. Like, that's just the way it should be. Mandem driving German with blacked-out windows leaning back. There's no blacked-out windows on this car, but there we go. Anyways, yeah, they should have really kept the sort of three-door design. Like, the last three-door Civic, I believe, was the 7th gen. Yeah, it isn't, but unfortunate. I mean, that's the way most hatchbacks are going, at least here in, Bonjour Pro Racing, welcome to Stram. I'm driving Porsche and playing new game, anyways. Yeah, all sort of modern hatchbacks, you know, the Peugeot 308, for example, that's only five doors. Ford Focus, the new Focus, I'm fairly certain is only a 5-door. Astra, I'm not sure, I haven't seen enough of those new Astras to know. It has indeed been a while. Do a London Racer 2 Let's Play. I've never played London Racer 2. From what I gather, London Racer 2 is actually much better than the first game, so yeah. I don't know if it'd be quite as funny, but I may look into it at some point. If I can find it cheap off eBay, like, potentially, that could be a thing. But we'll have to see, of course. I mean, I've been tortured enough with London Racers. You cannot spell no, you cannot. Anyways. Ooh, got high tail steer. Tail steer? Oversteer. There we go. Oh, God. Please, no. I struggle enough trying to read stuff normally because Ayla Mile dyslexic. Anyways. There we go. Through there. Nicely, nicely. Okay, so this race hasn't checked Discord. I shall check Discord. I'll check it on the loading screen of the next race queue. Yeah. The Cayman actually has fared a lot better in this race. I was expecting Silverstone National to perhaps be a little bit of a trickier track, I guess because it's much wider. It's obviously is a little bit easier to overtake on. Of course, the wider the track is, the more space you've got, and the less you're going to get spun out by other cars. I mean, that's the one kind of cool thing about Mugello is it can create tense racing. I just find, for the most part, Mugello, once you sort of pass the interesting racing, it's sort of... Oh, God. I don't want that to happen now. Why has that happened all of a sudden? Anyways, check that third monitor. Oh, please, no, not that. Like, that is the worst meme this channel has come up with. And I'm not joking. Durr plant. Anyways. Saving GAM data. As we move on to the next and final race, we've got 12,101 credits. We finally level up the car, and we're going to get 20% discount on anti-roll bars. And they're made by Audi, BMW, Mercedes, Porsche, Seat, and Volkswagen. Interesting. It's thundering. It's not thundering here. It's a sunny, sunny day here in England. Anyways, let's head to the final race today, which is at Mazda Raceway Laguna Seca. Right. Okay, there we go. HG Central confirmed. What? no, I don't think he's dealing with some other stuff right now. So, yeah, he won't be appearing for a while, one would assume. Anyways. Right, Laguna Seca, final race. Hopefully I don't get dicked by the corkscrew. This car does seem to want to slide a little bit. So, oh, hi. Let's dive up the inside of the turbo. You twat. You absolute tosspot. Look, and that's even inconvenienced you, you dick. Mark Webber. Twat. I hope his, like, first name's Mark. How loud is that keyboard? It's very, very close to my microphone. Also, it's, like, I don't know, it's the keyboard that came with this computer. So, I've had it for, like, 18 months. It's still fine. It's wireless, which, but it's not bad keyboard. Oh yeah, it's like literally, basically, in order to sort of space the microphone away from my face, I actually use my keyboard as sort of a thing to stop having the mic like right close in my face. So yeah, the keyboard is basically directly underneath my microphone, and of course my microphone is one of those that... Oh, how the hell did I damage the front aero? I didn't even do anything, anyways. Let's get him out of the way. I want to push him off into the sand so badly, but I'm not going to. The real racer. TRE is a racer. No, believe me, I live in the worst part of England than you do. I don't have a Corsa. Also, you said... Also, yeah, well, no, believe me, the monitor stuff is worse than that. It really is. Oh my God, okay, the turbo has come alive, either that or when he took out... I'm just going to restart this race. Okay, take two. I broke my aero. I don't know how I managed to break my aero, but basically, apparently I broke the aero. The 911 turbo spun me off in the first corner. And yeah, it just wasn't a pretty race, so I decided to go ahead and restart it. Anyways, let's actually see if we can get up the inside of the turbo without being spun up by said turbo. Nope, instead I'm going to crash myself on a GT3. Maybe I shouldn't have done that. Yeah, also, of course. I can hear people shouting. I don't know where from. I mean, the window's open, which probably isn't a good idea. VTEC kicked in, yo? Yeah, apparently so. The VTEC kicked in straight into the GT3's teeth, but there we go. Anyways, I guess that cuts out sort of the middle argument. Like, now I've just got an argue with the GT2, like the GT3. Usually I'd pass the GT3 by the first lap, but still, at least I guess we've moved on to the proper fight now, I guess. I don't know. Anyways, let's break into the corkscrew, try not to break the aero this time. I don't know if I just smacked that bump quite hard. Like, I wouldn't imagine that would upset the car too much, but I don't know. Either that, because the 911 turbo was directly in front of me, maybe the game just miscalculated how much damage was actually caused in the crash that we had, but there we go. Anyways, let's try and get up the inside of you, sir. Ooh, okay, he goes kind of wide there. Then again, yep, there we go. The Porsche definitely has VTEC, yes, because it's a great Porsche. I remember I saw a video with a 7-litre V8 in the back of a Porsche, and people were mad because someone had dared swapped out the horrible air-cooled unit for a V8 out of Corvette. To be fair, I was more upset with the... I think there was a Camaro swapped Impreza, like an Impreza with a... some form of American V8. That pissed me off more than anything. What is the best meme? None. All memes are terrible. Kappa. Anyways. Oh, God. Hype. There we go. Okay, we are going to go around him like that. Is that the way this is going to work? Okay, I'll take that. Anyways. Let's try not to get dive up the inside of... I took that relatively well. 0 out of 10. Not a rough RGT8. Oh, yeah, of course. This was before Forza found out about roof. Was it Forza 4? If your Porsche is malfunctioning, take your Beetle straight to your local Volkswagen or Porsche. Gershershaft. I don't know. I can do something with German. Not quite. Anyways. Technically, this one isn't a Beetle. I just want to throw this out there. I mean, it's mid-engined. You could call it the Cockster. I'm perfectly happy with calling this Cockster. Admittedly, I think the name Cockster should be just reserved for the Boxster, which is definitely the Cockster. Either 3 or 4. Yeah, because 3 had Porsche in from the start. I'm not sure if they had roofs. They could have had roofs, you know. It wouldn't surprise me. I don't know. 4? Definitely 4? Okay. Yeah, because I wasn't sure maybe 3 could have them, because, I mean, Porsche and roof do coexist. Surprisingly enough, Forza 6 actually has none of the roofs, which is kind of strange when you consider Forza 5 does. I don't know why they didn't pick up the licensing again. To be honest with you, it actually makes me kind of sad, because I really like the Yellow Bird, because that thing is just absolutely bloody nuts. But there we go. I guess we could see it in Gran Turismo, hardy dardy dirty dirty there. I love Gran Turismo. I don't think Gran Turismo quite gets the terror of the Yellow Bird correct. Like, say what you want about Forza 5, I have to say, that game makes the Yellow Bird the most terrifying thing known to man. Like, that car is basically... For those of you who haven't played with the Yellow Bird and haven't seen the Top Gear laps on Forza 5, basically the Yellow Bird, once you hit, I think it's like 120 miles an hour, and go through a fast corner, the front end will lift up. I'm not talking about the usual, like, three-wheeled stuff, which occasionally you see from cars. I'm talking both front wheels lift up, and yeah, that's not good, especially when you have, like, 600 horsepower. Why does Porsche and Subaru have to be awkward and produce flat-engine cars, hipsters? I don't know. I guess it works for them. I mean, there's other cars with boxer unit engines. I can't quite remember them off the top of my head. I guess it's kind of like Mazda and the rotary engines. It's just a nice little quirk each design team have. Like with, I don't know, with Subaru, I've never really understood why they specifically went with it, but whatever. I mean, I guess it's something. There we go. There's like a handlebar or something in the back of this car. Engined. Well, I read it at engined at least, so. What do you call a banker? What do I call a banker? I don't know, I haven't really met too many Ferrari produced the Boxer 12? When? When was this? I want to hear the noise that thing makes. I can imagine it was interesting. Like, IOV engines for the win. I don't know, I always manage to get them confused. Because, like, I don't get confused when I'm looking at them, I just want to point that out. I get confused when it comes to, like, sometimes I will turn around and say, oh, you know, this car's a V6, and then people are like, no, it has an inline thick. And it's like, oh, okay. Anyways. Yeah, I want to hear that Boxer 12 in action. I can imagine that thing sounds interesting. Anyways, I think the GT2 took out the number 2 braking board there at some point. I don't know. Anyways, pretty uneventful race. Not quite as uneventful as Silverstone, but nevertheless, we are across the line with the Cayman. And here we go. Anyways, we get 12,067 credits. I think I got charged slightly for the damage, but not too much. Anyways, we get a 10% discount on driveline and transmission upgrades, and that's available to any Porsches. So if we decide to use another Porsche, then there we go. Anyways, that's it for this. We get a bonus of 12,000 credits, and for beating the race, we get access to a Red Bull car. Oh, hey, oh, that's a... I know this game has the 996 GT Cup cars from... oh my god, look at the wing on that. It's the winged beast. Anyways. Yeah, that thing's crazy. Anyways, that's the end of the Porsche Sports Car Cup. And with that, of course, it is the end of the episode. In the next episode, not quite sure what we're going to be doing, but stay tuned for it. Anyways, friends, I want to thank you all very much for watching. My name's been The Rail Mail. Until next time, farewell.